Thank you, Madam Speaker. To the bill.
To the bill.
Colleagues, I am a no vote. While I appreciate very much the hard work of Representative McLean and Representative Brock Smith, the bill raises concerns as it relates to efforts on the federal level to roll back provisions of the Waters of the United States rule under the Clean Water Act. While our colleagues were trying to build a house, the Trump administration was undermining the foundations. We probably all heard the analogy that the forests of the world as the lungs of the earth, exchanging harmful gases for life-sustaining oxygen. Well, wetlands play a more prosaic role. If forests are the lungs, wetlands are the liver, cleaning toxins and pollution from the water we all need to live. Most of us don't dedicate much thought to our livers, but you'd sure miss yours if it was gone. Before there was widespread agriculture in Oregon, there were extensive wetlands due to regular flooding. As agriculture and damming expanded, those wetlands shrank and pollution increased. As wetlands grew smaller, the need for them grew greater. Eventually, on the federal level, we passed the Clean Water Act to protect our remaining wetlands, to save the little liver we had left. President Trump has proposed a rollback of the Waters of the United States rule, which would leave 51% of wetlands and 18% of intermittent streams that are currently covered by the Clean Water Act completely unprotected. Oregon's current removal and fill laws serve as a shield to some of what would be lost if President Trump's Waters of the U.S. rule is adopted. Currently, the removal of fill and the removal and fill process exempts up to 50 yards per linear mile of ditches, about 3.5 dump truck loads, not an inconsiderable amount, and provides an expedited process between 50 and 100 cubic yards, and then requires notification and consultations with agencies, including DEQ, regarding water quality impacts and a permit. House Bill 2437 would increase the exemption to 3,000 cubic yards. That's about 250 dump truck loads, a 5,900% increase. Projects under that level would merely require a notice process to ODA and ODFW, both of which receive less than one FTE to do this work. Department of State Lands retains the authority to deny the request, but receives no additional budget to do so, nor does DEQ, the agencies designed to protect our waters. We currently have a system set up to fail. I don't think anybody disputes that. And we are proposing a new system that is equally set up to fail through underfunding. Worse than the maintenance provisions on this bill are the fill provision. The Waters of the U.S. rule change will leave isolated wetlands solely under state regulations. The provisions of this bill do little to enforce the protection of isolated wetlands, which are a critical piece of maintaining water quality by providing for the slow release of water from storms into river. Many farmers will use this bill to fill isolated wetlands, and we're doing almost nothing in this bill to make sure they don't. It cedes most enforcement authority to the Oregon Department of Agriculture, which is not proven to be an effective protector of the environment. Indeed, the law prohibits ODFW from inspecting for compliance unless accompanied by ODA, undermining the very Salmonid predictions that are written into the bill. Let's not kid ourselves. This bill is everything that ag wants and will do little to protect the environment from the impacts of those activities. Earlier this session, the legislature passed House Bill 2250, otherwise known as Oregon's Environmental Protection Act. By passing this law, we assured our citizenry that we as a state would prevent against environmental backsliding. House Bill 2437 goes against that commitment. Again, I honor the work that has been done, but we are not done here. I do not believe that the ramifications of the proposed federal rollback of the Waters of the U.S. rule have been adequately considered in relation to this bill. Colleagues, our metaphorical liver is hanging by a thread, and the federal government is looking to cut it. I urge a no vote.